Welcome back. So let's create our first Python file and start writing some basic code. Okay, so right click on your project, new, and select Python file. Okay, and here you can start saying first demo. You can give any file name. All right, so now first demo.py. It comes with Python extension .py. Alright, so first one, to print anything in console using Python, you use a keyword called print. Okay, print hello. So if you want to print this in the output, the simple way to run this Python file is right click and you can say run first demo, because this is our file, right? So run first demo, that will run the file and give you the output of hello. So this is the one way, or you have a shortcut to run, which is Control Shift and F10. Okay, that also give you the same output. So in this course I will use the shortcut frequently, which is Control Shift F10 to run the program. You can use that, or you can just right click and run your first demo. Different ways of doing it in this PyCharm editor. So now you know how to print anything in the output. If you are familiar with Java, this is like system.outprintln. Instead, in Python, we just have a print. Okay. Now, if you want to write any comments in the file, you have to start with this mark, and then you can actually start typing anything. Here are the comments I have defined. So Python will not pick if the comments start with this character. Alright, so if you execute again, that should not interrupt your line number 3 for your test. Right, so basically when we write a program, it's good to have some comments to tell what the program is doing, and you can comfortably write the comments with starting with this hash character, and then you can go ahead and write whatever lines you want. Alright, so this is how you define comments in Python. Next, variable. Let's say you want to create variable. So the simple way of creating variables in Python is, you know, let's say a equals to 3. That's it. So you have declared a variable called a, and the value in that variable is 3. So how different is this variable declaration compared to other programming languages? So the only point here is that you don't have return type. In Python, you need not give any return type to tell what type of value it is. If you are working with Java, you have to say like int a equals to 3 to explicitly inform that the number, whatever you are storing here, is integer data type. But in Python, it's not required. It will automatically calculate that run data type at runtime. So you need not give that. Python have knowledge of what kind of data type it is once you pass that into the variable, which is cool, right? So now if you want to print this variable, print a, run this Control Shift F10, and you see that 3 is printed in your output. So that means you have successfully printed a variable after you created it, and there is no data type. There are data types in Python. That doesn't mean that data types does not exist in Python. They are present, but you need not mention them explicitly while creating variables. So that's the concept. Now, let's say str equals to 5. Sorry, let's have some string. Hello world. Right? Now, it's a string, right? You need not worry about anything. It will print the string. Here you pass an integer, it will print the integer. So That's the beauty with Python. So you will don't have a headache of having the return type. Next. So you can actually define multiple variables in single line itself. Now, for example, let me create three more variables called B, comma C, comma D equals to, right? I would say 5, and this is like decimal point, and another is string. Great, something like that. Right. Now, if you carefully observe this particular line, I just created three variables and respectively I have given values to them. So once I create this line, number 5 will go to the variable B, 6.4 will go to the C, and great will go to the D. Okay, so three variables you can simultaneously create with their respective values so that it stores it in the order it has placed. Okay, you need not have three more lines to actually create variables like this. And also do remember that in Python there is no colon at the end. Unlike Java or C sharp, you should not give any colon at the end. And particularly this PyCharm editor take code indentation very seriously. When I say code indentation, it is like a rules where you have to define the code in some format. Okay, it's not about the syntax, but it's about how you are defining the code in such a format. Now, for example, if I remove the space, it's no more harmful. Code will still run and you will get the output. But if you see, there is some kind of error here. So this is not the error which stops your execution, but from code indentation perspective, so PyCharm complains saying that it's nice to have space. You see that missing white space after. But that doesn't mean that your test will not run if there is no white space. It will run, but it's nice to have space so that error will go away. These are a format where we generally follow, and people say this as a code indentation. You can just Google that word. So you have to strictly follow the coding standards basically when you write the code. So PyCharm have that code indentation plugin by default so that whenever you write some code, it will check whether you are following proper coding standards with proper spaces and alignment, everything is not. Okay, right. Even if you remove the space here, it looks good. So that means there is no problem. Sometimes even it complains you need to have some space. So basically, once you're familiar with this editor, within few lectures, you will understand what are the coding standards, and automatically you will have that in your test. Alright, so that's pretty much about this lecture. We have seen some basic about how to print it in the console, how to have a comments, and how to declare variables and declare variables together in the same line. Alright, let's continue in our next lecture. Thank you.